Now, this thing is burning in complex terrain and complex vegetation. This is more than just grass this time. Now we're seeing a lot of vegetation, whole trees going up, the kind of fire behavior we've not seen so far this year. As you can see from Live Copter 3, we do have structures in the area. There's active structure protection going on, and we've been able to see this smoke plume from miles away, but we can also see it in other ways too. Let's go over to Heather on that.
Yeah, Mark, we've got a few different ways that we can watch this plume of smoke, and it's now large enough that even the radar is picking up on it. You see towards the end of the loop here, this is the last 3 hours. At first you see noise, but then you see a very clearly defined plume. The way the radar works, sends out a beam of radiation. Once that radiation hits something that it's too big for it to pass through, it bounces back, goes back to the radar, tells it what it saw. But the thing is, it doesn't distinguish between rain, snow, sleet, or in this case, smoke particles. So you're seeing that clear as day here, and you can also get an idea for which way the wind is blowing. It's coming from the southwest, blowing things up the hill there. You can also see it from the satellite image here, very high resolution image where you can see a true color picture of the smoke. So interesting ways that we can use our weather tools to track the smoke.